we first go to the folder in which the message types are defined. Using the rosscd hrwross_msgs command. Then we go to the msg folder. In this folder, we first create the message file sensorinformation.msg. In the code snippet in our previous video, we saw that the ROS sensor message type was written as sensor_messages/range. And there are also several sensor message types supported in ROS, and we can see them by using the ROS msg command. We just type ROS msg show sensor_msgs/ and hit the tab key. As you can see, there is a message type for battery state information, there is one for joystick, there's one for distance, temperature, and so forth. And we need the range sensor. So let's type range and hit enter. And now we see the contents of the range sensor message type. So we have a placeholder for timing information and reference frame information. Then we have the radiation type, which can be either of ultrasound or infrared. And since we have an ultrasound sensor in our case, we will use the corresponding value. Then we have a placeholder for the field of view of the sensor. Then the min and max range and the actual distance value itself. Note that if we use the minus R switch, the ROS MSG with the ROS MSG command, we will also see the comments explaining what these variables mean. Of course, assuming the authors wrote comments. Well, these authors here did a great job. Kudos to them for having such clear descriptions. By the way, sensor messages are not the only ROS message types out there. If we look up the common_messages ROS stack, we will find a whole collection of ROS message types. Check them out. Then, in our favorite editor, we type in the contents of the message file. A placeholder for a ROS sensor message type, sensor_data. A placeholder for a string, which is called maker_name. And a placeholder for an unsigned integer, part_number. And of course, we write all the comments by the side. Then we add the studentinformation.msg file to the cmaklists.txt file in the hrwross_messages folder. We will add our new message type in the add_message_file section of the cmaklists.txt file. And we can see that there are a few other message type definitions here as well. And then we run the catkin build command, which creates an importable Python object for the new message type. As beginner level users of ROS, let's just follow these steps as protocol and not worry about the finer details behind what these commands are doing. Such details are beyond the scope of this course. And lastly, we check the contents of our newly defined ROS message type with the ROS msg show command. So we have the ROS sensor message type range along with the two new data types that we added to it. All right then, let's build our first ROS application. Basically, two ROS nodes that talk to each other with the new message type.